I'm the Mohawk, and on the Hawk Rants, I want to talk about something that happened quite recently.
Fans and the world alike woke up to the news of Chester Bennington, lead singer of Linkin Park, who had died at the age of 41 due to possible suicide.
Now, as a fan of Linkin Park, I found this news personally saddening. But what made me even sadder were some of the comments on Facebook by people saying you should not glorify suicide and looking at the whole situation from a different perspective, even people who are public figures themselves, like
Korn guitarist Brian Welch, or better known as Head, is slammed online for calling Linkin Park frontman Chester Bennington a coward just hours after his death.
Now, I'm trying to be empathetic to this point of view, where I do agree that suicide should not be glorified, but at the same time, I think that they're not asking the key question. Why did he commit suicide?
In an interview with The Independent, Chester Bennington discusses his depression in a final interview, where he says, "I can either just give up and effing die, or I can fight."
From this article, we can see that Chester Bennington had a history of fighting depression at some point in his life and probably was battling depression in the daily. Now, there are a lot of things we do not understand about depression, and only in recent studies have we discovered the effects of depression on the human mind. And the thing is, because Chester Bennington's situation is actually very similar to another big artist.
As we can see from this article from Men's Health, it seems that Chris Cornell also suffered from depression before his suicide.
Now, when we have two cases that are amazingly similar, we have to ask the question, how is depression really affecting people? And is it something that we can prevent, or something that we can do, or something that we can understand more of? Now, from a scientific perspective, this is what a recent study had said.
Dr. Heather Whaley and Professor Andrew McIntosh and colleagues from the Center for Cognitive Aging and Cognitive Epidemiology and the University of Glasgow have found, using diffusion tensor imaging, that white matter integrity is reduced in people with symptoms indicative of depression compared to those without.
So based on this study, and of course if you read the rest of it, you can see that those who are going through depression, their brain composition is slightly different from those who are not depressed. Depression itself changes the white matter composition in the brain, which affects the way emotions work, the way people perceive the world, and maybe there are things that people who are going through depression cannot control. Those are the questions that we need to ask. We need to look at mental health slightly different than we already do.
Now, in this article of Newsweek writes, "That's the lesson suicide prevention experts hope the public will grasp in the wake of the two high-profile celebrity suicides, first Chris Cornell and now Chester Bennington. Your mental health is health," says Jill Harkavy Friedman, the Vice President of Research at the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention. "If you have a nice car and a lot of money, that doesn't protect you from mental health conditions."
Now, in conclusion, instead of just condemning someone for their actions, maybe we should look deeper into the situation. I'm not saying that I have all the answers, I'm just a guy doing a video, but I hope I ask the right questions that we can all have a healthy discussion about mental health. And in this day and generation, how much do we really understand about the mind? And what have we learned so far that we can change the way things are? Once again, I'm the Mohawk, and I hope you enjoyed this week's The Hawk Rants. And if you have any opinions of your own that you want to contribute to the discussion, please let me know in the comment section.